Hello everyone. So in this video we are going to check the solutions for the daily dose 3. So basically we post daily aptitude or technical practice questions in our WhatsApp group. So if you want to be a part of our WhatsApp group and check out these daily aptitude questions, kindly message us on this particular number 8459943139. Okay, this is especially for 2021 batch students. So you can just WhatsApp us on this number and we will add you to the placement preparation group, wherein we post daily aptitude and technical practice questions and also give solutions for them. So in this video, we are going to check the solutions for daily dose 3. So just read this question. A class consists of 20 boys and 30 girls. So 20 boys and 30 girls. In the mid-semester examination, the average score of the girls was 5 higher than that of the boys. In the final exam, however, the average score of the girls dropped by 3, while the average score of the entire class increased by 2. The increase in the average score of boys is. So let's go stepwise. It is not that much difficult. Okay, so first let us consider the average score of girls in mid-sem exam. So average score of girls in mid-sem exam, we can consider it as suppose G. Okay, then we can say that average score of boys will in the mid-sem exam, it will be how much? It will be definitely G minus 5. Why? Because they have said in mid-semester exam, the average score of girls was 5 higher than that of boys. So if I say average score of girls is G, then definitely average score of boys will be 5 less, because girls score is 5 higher than boys. So boys average score in mid-sem exam will be G minus 5. Now, in the final exam, they are saying the average score of the girls dropped by 3. Now, before going for that particular sentence, just check here. We know that total number of girls are 30 and total number of boys is 20. Now, if average score of girls in mid-sem is G, then total score of girls in mid-sem exam. Okay, total score of girls in mid-sem exam will be how much? It will be definitely 30 multiplied by G. Because we know that average is nothing but total divided by number. Okay. So total score of girls in mid-sem exam will be 30 into G. Since average was G, total score divided by number of girls is 30. So total score will be 30 G. Similarly, total score of boys in mid-sem exam will be how much? It will be definitely number of boys into average. So it will be 20 into G minus 5. So what will be the total score of whole class? Total score of whole class will be 30G plus 20G minus 100. So it will be 50G minus 100. So this is the total score of class in mid-sem. Okay. So what is the average of entire class? Average of entire class will be nothing but total score divided by number of students, that is T, because 20 boys and 30 girls. So this will be equal to G minus 2. You can just cancel out and find that the average of whole class in mid-sem exam is G minus 2. Now this, whatever we have calculated, is currently for mid-sem exam. Now let us check what happens for the final exam. So now what happens in the final exam? They have said average score of girls drops by 2. So previously average score of girls was G. Now average score of girls, okay, in final exam, it drops by 3, means now the average is G minus 3. Okay. Next, they have also told that the average score of entire class increased by 2. What was the average of entire class for mid-sem? It was G minus 2. Now the average of entire class increased by 2 in final exam. So average of full class, okay, in final exam has increased by 2, so it will be g minus 2 plus 2, so it will be g. Now what we need to find, we need to find the increase in the average score of boys. First, let us find what is the total of full class. Since the average of full class is g, total of full class will be equal to how much? It will be 50 multiplied by g. Again, I'll repeat, we know that average is total upon number. So average is g, number of students are 50. So 50 into g is the total. Let us find the total of girls. Total of girls in the final exam will be how much? Number of girls is 30 multiplied by average is g minus 3. Now, it is a simple logic that total of girls in final exam plus total of boys in final exam will be equal to the total of full class, right? So total of girls is how much? 30g minus 90 plus total of boys will be equal to total of full class is 50g. So I can say that total of boys is nothing but 20g plus 90. Okay, now we have got the total. We have still not got the average. So let us calculate the average. How we can find the average? Average will be nothing but total of boys divided by number of boys, right? So this average will be turning to g plus 4.5. Am I right? So now what we need to find? We need to find the increase in the average score of boys. So previously the average score of boys was g minus 5. Now the average score of boys in the final exam is g plus 4.5. So what is the increase? Increase will be nothing but g plus 4.5 minus g minus 5. So from this we will get gg gets cancelled. So it will be equal to 9.5. So the increase in the average score of boys is option A, 9.5. So the main motto of this particular video is to solve different kind of questions. If you are weak in the basic concepts itself, I'll recommend you to go and check out the Aptitude Cracker course on our website, which will clear your basic concepts. It is very important that you first get cleared with the basic concepts and then jump to these particular problems. If you are good with basics, then these problems will help you a lot. Let's check the next question. Read this question. A test has 50 questions. A student scores 1 mark for a correct answer, minus 1 by 3 for a wrong answer, and minus 1 by 6 for not attempting a question. If the net score of a student is 32, the number of questions answered wrongly by that student cannot be less than. Okay, so let's check how we can solve. First, let us form equations. Let us consider number of correct questions as x, incorrect questions as y, and not attempted questions as z. Okay, so I can say that correct questions plus incorrect questions plus not attempted questions, together there are 50 questions. So this can be first equation. Next, 1 mark for correct answer. So if he gives x correct, then he will get total x marks. Y is the incorrect number of questions, so minus 1 by 3 into y, and number of questions not attempted are z, so he will get minus 1 by 6 into z. So x minus y by 3 minus z by 6, this is nothing but the total score or the net score, which is going to be 32. So if we solve this, we'll get 6x minus 2y minus z is equal to 32. So this will be equal to 6x minus 2y minus z is equal to 192. So this is second equation. So just add these two equations. So this will become x plus 6x, 7x. This will become minus y. Z will get cancelled and will be equal to 242. So I can say x is equal to 242 plus y divided by 7. Now just use your logic. X is nothing but number of correct questions. So X is an integer. It cannot be in decimal. If it cannot be in decimal, that means 242 plus y should be divisible by 7. Now let us check what is the minimum value which y can take. Y is nothing but the number of questions answered wrongly or the incorrect questions, and we need to find the number of questions answered wrongly cannot be less than. That means we need to find the least number of possible incorrect questions. Okay. So now if incorrect questions are 0, so 242 is not divisible by 7. So x will become in decimal, which is not possible. So y cannot be equal to 0. Okay. Next, if y is 1, again 243 is not divisible by 7 because x will be in again in decimal, which is not possible because we know x is an integer. Next, 242 plus 3, so which will be equal to 245. So 245, is it divisible by 7? Yes, it is divisible by 7. So I can say y can take the least possible value is 3. If you take y as 2 also, so it will be 244 divided by 7, which is again not divisible by 7, so x again becomes decimal. So y is equal to 3 is the least possible. So the number of questions answered wrongly by the student cannot be less than 3. Okay, so it is 3 or greater than 3. So answer is C. Let's check the next question. So read this question. The area of the closed region bounded by the equation x plus y, modulus of x plus modulus of y is equal to 2, in the two dimensional plane is. Okay, so first check, so what are the values which x and y can take? So basically x, if x is 0, y is equal to 2, then modulus of 0 plus modulus of 2 will be equal to 2. So similarly, x can take 0 and y can take minus 2. Similarly, x can take 2 and y can take 0, and x can take minus 2, y can take 0, right? So if you just plot this on the x and y axis, okay, so just check x0 and y2. So x0 and y2, the point will be over here, okay? X0 and y minus 2, the point will be over here, right? X2, y0, so it will be over here, and x minus 2, y0, it will be over here. So if you check, this particular equation creates a closed region, which is nothing but a square. Okay, so this is nothing but a square. Now what they want us to find? They want us to find the area. Now we know that this length is 2, this is 2, this is 2, and this is 2. So we need to find the side of this square. So we need to find this x. So in this particular triangle, this is a right angle triangle. So I can find x, I can use Pythagoras theorem. So 2 square plus 2 square will be equal to x square. So x square will be equal to 8. Side will be equal to, x will be equal to root 8. So once I get side, I can easily find area. Area is nothing but x square, which is equal to root 8 square, which is 8 units. So the correct answer for this question is C. Let's check the next question on verbal ability. So such kind of questions generally come under the topic of idioms, phrases, or it is also known as contextual vocabulary. Okay, or sometimes it is also known as one word substitution. Okay, so what you need to do, just check, select the answer option which gives the correct meaning of the underlined part in the sentence. Just check the first sentence. People cry over the spilt milk when they do not execute tasks with proper planning. So the part which is underlined is cry over the spilt milk. So basically this, you should not take the literal meaning. You need to find out what is the contextual meaning. So basically just check, first word is weep, which is crying. So this does not work over here. C is fail. So it does not work. Crying over the spilt milk means repenting. Okay, so repent is something like once you make a mistake, feeling bad about it. That is repenting. Okay, so the correct answer for this is B, So you should not take literal meaning like crying over the spilled milk. So it means the contextual meaning is repenting. Okay. Next, the company checks out all new employees. So checks out all new employees. The meaning is that examines. Okay. It does not mean stares at. It does not mean ignores, or it does not mean pays. Checking out is examining. So such type of questions are generally asked in contextual vocabulary, one word substitution, or idioms and phrases. So for becoming perfect in such type of topics, you need to make sure you practice a lot of questions. So thank you for watching the video. If you like the video, then press the like button and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.